Hi. Assalamu alaikum. I'm Yana Mir. I'm Kashmiri Muslim. और मैं आप सब के साथ अपने व्यूज शेयर करना चाहती हूँ रिगार्डिंग बहुत सारे टॉपिक्स जिसको लेके इंडियंस काफ़ी कंफ्यूज्ड हैं. बाय पीपल व्हाट डू यू मीन? आई मीन इफ यू मीन द लोकल्स और डू यू मीन द पॉलिटिशियंस? बिकॉज वी हैव अ ह्यूज बिग सेटअप ऑफ पॉलिटिशियंस डायनास. दे आर ऑब्वियसली नॉट हैप्पी विद इट. बट इफ यू टॉकिंग अबाउट द लोकल्स देन येस दे आर वेरी हैप्पी क्योंकि उनके हिसाब से कुछ चेंज हुआ ही नहीं है. उनको जो चाहिए था, आई मीन व्हाट डिड दे वांट? दे वांटेड टू अर्न, दे वांटेड अ नॉर्मल लाइफ, दे वांट एजुकेशन फॉर देयर किड्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट इज नॉट गेटिंग अफेक्टेड बाय एब्रोगेशन ऑफ 370. सो इट डजंट रियली अफेक्ट देम. ऑब्वियसली दे वांट, व्हाट डू वी वांट? व्हाट डू आवर पेरेंट्स वांट? द सेम थिंग. दे वांट दैट देयर किड्स शुड बी सेफ, यंगस्टर्स शुड बी यू नो डूइंग समथिंग विद देयर लाइव्स, विद देयर फ्यूचर, नॉट गेटिंग इनटू मिलिटेंसी. दे वांट जॉब्स, दे वांट डेवलपमेंट. And just like what everybody else from other states of India want, that's what Kashmiris want. Now again, it depends on what do you mean by normalcy. Markets are open, yes, they're open. Schools are open, colleges are open. Everyone's free to walk out of their houses. There's no curfew anywhere. The Jamia Masjid was closed for prayers, but now that's also open. So I mean, there's nothing that's really abnormal going on there, except that there's a lot of peace. There hasn't been a lot of, you know, inciting and invoking people, mass protesting and all of that. That has stopped. That used to be the normal before. It's not there anymore. So I guess Kashmir is actually looking at more peaceful times at the moment. And if you the only thing that of course is missing there that doesn't seem normal is the internet, and which should be restored soon. Yes, they were totally justified. I'll give you an example. There are no internet restrictions in the rest of India. And look how much confusion is being spread because of the CAA and NRC decisions by the government. There is so much confusion, and that confusion is spreading like a domino effect thanks to internet. Okay, but the good thing is that people are not killing each other in the rest of India. Because of confusion spreading in Kashmir, people were actually getting killed. You know, and thanks to the internet, people, you know, it's like militants used to just barge into homes of civilians and shoot civilians down. You know, and our soldiers are losing their lives, and even I'm talking about even the local civilians, innocents are getting picked up by forces, even though they're not stone pelting, because they were just you know, walking past a stone pelting site. So I mean, everybody was facing problems because of militancy and these kind of things. I think they're just plain ignorant or stupid, and I don't think they should you know, encourage such things. Because we do have a section of people, and I'm not just saying Kashmiris, we do have a section of Muslims in the rest of India also who don't stand up for national anthem, who don't like to say Vande Mataram, you know. And this is just acts like these. I don't know if they're doing it out of ignorance or they're doing it out of ego or what, but acts like these are going to encourage the anti-national Muslim community that we have in India. See, there used to be a very small section that was provoked by organizations like Horiyat. That very, very small section of people that used to think that Kashmiris should actually belong to Pakistan. Because if you've seen how Mr. Gilani, who's right now on his deathbed, if you've seen what kind of you know, slogans he used to chant, he used to literally provoke people against India and into thinking that they belong to Pakistan. So, but that's a very small section, and like I said, now Huriyat has lost all its power. So that section is like, you know, it's better to be, you know, ignored. The remaining Kashmiris, yes, there is a big section of them who feel that they should be independent. But the only reason they feel so is because they feel that being with India has not given them any benefit. In fact, all this terrorism and all that's not ended. Lives are still going. They were still losing lives, and development was not kicking forward. So there was a lot of things they felt. Okay, you know, we don't want to be with either Pakistan or India. Let us just be independent. Leave us alone. But I think eventually, now that 370 has been abrogated, and like I said, if they start looking at the development, if Kashmir starts developing like Gujarat, for example, or like Maharashtra, then I think they'll have no problems. This section will have no problems in proudly calling themselves Indian. They just need to feel secure that a Hindu majority governance will take care of Muslims, will take care of a Muslim majority union territory. They need to have that faith, and I think that will eventually develop. There are a lot of youngsters in the valley who are nationalistic, like myself. I don't live there, but I have a lot of friends who are actually dedicated full time into going house to house and explaining to people that there's nothing to worry about now that the 370 is gone, and that the Indian government will actually take Kashmir to new heights of development and prosperity. It destroyed Kashmir completely, because these dynasties, they were like using Kashmir like a volleyball, you know, kabhi mere haath mein, kabhi tere haath mein. It's like when they are in power, they sing slogans for India, Bharat Mata Ki Jai. And when the volleyball is in the other dynasty's court, so this dynasty starts talking anti-India rhetoric. And what does this do? And the same, and vice versa. When the volleyball is on this side, the other dynasty starts talking anti-India rhetoric. So what does this do? The anti-India rhetoric, it did nothing but increased, the feeling of hatred that some sections of the Kashmiri society already had for the Indian governance. That was the darkest period of the Kashmir Valley, I feel, and the darkest point of history of Kashmir. And that is something that majority of Kashmiri Muslims also repent. Not that they were part of it, because this was completely set up by the Pakistan proxy and the militant groups. But of course, Kashmiri Muslims have lost their reputation because of this. And they long for their Pandit brothers to come back to the valley. And they hate themselves in a way for not having been able to do anything to protect them. There were about 116 laws that were not implemented in Kashmir thanks to Article 370's existence. So, and these are all for the benefit of the people. So, as they get implemented, as people start seeing the results, I think they will actually realize what normal is, actually. And what prosperity is, what development is, they'll start seeing it slowly, slowly. It's a matter of time. I think we just have to be patient, and we have to keep going at it with a positive intention. Yes. They are, in fact, I've released videos before where I've said that they are very loving people. I think they are the most loving of all communities in India, to be very frank. Once they think of someone as their own, they'll even give their life. You must have even heard stories of how some tourist guides have given up their lives to save tourists. So that is the kind of love they have. So it's just a matter of time before, I know there is some section that does not, that feels that they need to be independent, they need to be a separate state or whatever. I know there is one section of Kashmiris who think like that. There are also some Kashmiri Hindus who think like that, that Kashmir should entirely be separate. It's not only Kashmiri Muslims, let me bring it to your notice. There are also some Hindus who support independence. But I think eventually, as like I said, it's a matter of time. When development kicks in, prosperity kicks in, I think they'll understand that India doesn't mean harm. India is our own. We are culturally Indians. We are not culturally Chinese. We are not culturally even Pakistanis. Because Kashmiriyat basically means it's the most secular of all communities. So if they become Pakistanis, they'll be completely Islamic. That's not what Kashmiriyat is all about. So eventually they'll realize that India is what we culturally belong to. And eventually that emotional sentiment will also kick in as the development starts coming in.